The current transfer portal recruiting class has been quite literally a very insane class with quarterbacks. As we've seen quarterbacks such as Quinn Ewers, Dylan Gabriel, Spencer Rattler, Max Johnson, Kendon Slovis, Zach Calzada, Harrison Bailey, Adrian Martinez, and Michael Penix Jr. are currently in the portal, and some of them are already going to their new schools, like Quinn to Texas, Gabriel to UCLA, Rattler to South Carolina, Max Johnson to Texas A&M, Martinez to K-State, and Penix to Washington. None of these quarterbacks are going to be the topic of today's video, as this is B. Kelly, back again with another banger video. And today's video, y'all, I am going to be talking about the top quarterback prospect according to 24/7 Sports that is currently available right now in Cameron Ward and his story from unranked high school recruit to one of the hottest commodities in the portal right now. And before I move on with the video, remember to smash that like button and subscribe if you haven't already, as we are on the road to 10K. Now let's get into it. To start this video off, we're going to take it to West Columbia, Texas, at Columbia High School, when Cameron was the starting quarterback for them. He was a two-year starting quarterback on the varsity level for Columbia High as a junior and a senior. He led them to a 6-4 record as a starter as a junior, and as a senior, he led them to a 9-1 record. You may be thinking that Cameron might have been a really good high school quarterback if he's seen as a top prospect right now in the portal, that this guy was putting up video game-like numbers in high school. But that is far from the truth. In fact, you could say that Cameron was very limited because of the offense that was ran. And to keep it real, Cameron was 100% limited in his role as the starting quarterback at Columbia High School while he was there. His high school ran a wing T offensive system, which is not really used in football today, nor at the college level. And this system does not favor quarterbacks at all. In fact, they were not really much of a passing team at all with Cameron. Cameron's best season in high school, in fact, his numbers weren't even really that impressive for a starting quarterback on the high school level. And it's mainly because of the system. He was not really throwing the ball all that much. He threw for 1,070 yards, completed 58% of his passes, 7 touchdowns, and 3 interceptions, averaging 118 passing yards per game. He would also have 4 rushing touchdowns in this season, and for his senior year, he really had to ball out and put up some big numbers to get a lot more attention with offers. But that was not really the case for him, as, like I said, this is an offense that does not favor quarterbacks at all. And in fact, he attempted less passing attempts as a senior than he did as a junior. In his senior year, he threw for 948 yards, completing 45% of his passes, 8 touchdowns, and 5 interceptions. He only averaged 95 passing yards per game, and on the ground, he did have 5 touchdowns. Although Cameron did, in fact, have a lot of potential to be a quarterback on the Division I level, a lot of teams and schools were very hesitant to pull the trigger on Cameron because of the system that was ran at his high school. Not many people run that system, and he wasn't really able to show his abilities as a quarterback in that system. People knew he could throw the ball well, and he had a good arm, but it was the system that was ran. There wasn't really a lot of film on him as a true quarterback, so not many teams were really looking at Cameron at all. Cameron had great size for a quarterback, but it was the system that was ran in high school that was his ultimate downfall as a high school recruit. According to 24/7 Sports, in the 2020 recruiting class, Cameron was an unranked recruit and held 2 Division I offers on the FCS level from Texas Southern and Incarnate Word. He would end up choosing Incarnate Word over the likes of Texas Southern. The expectations for Cameron going into the University of Incarnate Word wasn't to be the next great quarterback immediately, or to exactly be the starting quarterback to start it off. But he proved everybody wrong, as he was their main quarterback right away as a true freshman in the spring of the 2021 season. They would play in 6 games in the spring of 2021, as they would end up with a 3-3 record, and Cameron would have a great year for a first-year starting quarterback at the Division I level, as he would end up throwing for 2,260 yards, 24 touchdowns, and 4 interceptions, while completing a good amount of his passes. For a quarterback being in his first year in a system where he can actually be a quarterback and not a guy in a system that doesn't favor quarterbacks like he did in high school, he had a great season. And heading into the fall 2021 campaign, he was the starting quarterback and he was seen as a top 10 quarterback on the FCS level. The team and Cameron Smith were out for blood heading into 2021 as they had a lot of expectations. As they were a good team, they just lost a few games, but they wanted to prove to everyone that they could be a real team in this league. And they certainly did, as they would end up going 10-3, made it to the NCAA FCS playoffs. They beat Stephen F. Austin round 1, but then would unfortunately lose to the number 1 seed in Sam Houston the next round by 7 points. Cameron would have a career season, as he threw for 47 touchdowns that led all FCS passers to go along with 4,648 passing yards, which was third nationally, while completing 65% of his passes. The future of Incarnate Word football was looking very bright, as Cameron was still a very young quarterback, and he was developing at an insanely fast rate. I mean, this is a guy that was in a limited high school system for quarterbacks, that was the FCS True Freshman of the Year in the spring of 2021, and he had a great season and was a top quarterback on the FCS level in the fall of 2021. Unfortunately, Incarnate Word's coach would end up leaving after this historic 10-3 season, and this would ultimately lead to Cameron entering the transfer portal. And when Cameron entered the portal, he instantly became one of the most sought-after players in the portal, especially at the quarterback position, as there's coaches on the Power 5 level, the Group of 5 level, even the FCS level that are now trying to get Cameron to be their next quarterback. A Power 5 coach even told 24/7 Sports, "This dude is an absolute freak." Although he is in the portal, that doesn't mean he's going to leave Incarnate Word. In fact, he is open to going back. But he's getting a lot of interest from a lot of teams, Power 5, Group of 5, and FCS level. And the big thing with Cameron, it was reported that his number one thing he wants is to be in a system that throws the football. Cameron and his family have been open about being on a passing team where he can grow as a quarterback and develop his skill set even more so he can have the best shot that he can have to go to the NFL. Because he's not exactly the most, like, experienced quarterback with throwing the ball. Like I said earlier, he was in a high school system that was limited to his role as a quarterback, and he really didn't throw the ball all that much. It honestly is still pretty insane to think about that Cameron is still pretty new to being a pass-dominant quarterback. As you know, like I said a lot in the video, he was limited on high school, but the guy is still balling out. He balled out in the spring, and he's balled out a lot in the fall, and he's seen as a top prospect in the portal right now. Well, guys, if you made it this far in the video, drop something down in the comments below for future video suggestions, and before you head out, remember to smash that like button, turn on those post notifications, and subscribe for more videos. B. Kelly out.